inability to be professional is clear. Your inability to be professional is extremely clear. Whether you're Alex Earl going to a Taylor Swift concert to brag about all your successes, which are actual failures. See, that's the twisted mind sense of lacking reality, of living in delusion, that most of you don't quite understand, that she's actually failing miserably in life. She just paints the picture of herself succeeding. Or showing up in Atlanta, acting like a ghetto-ass black girl named Lizzo, who has always shown her desperation for attention and her lack of intelligence, self-respect, and confidence. Then she stands on a little podium attempting to drive the market for her sales of records while jumping off the back of black Americans. That is what we're watching with Kamala Harris's campaign. When a person is at a political rally and the whole entire audience starts ghetto dancing and rocking to the same beat in the audience, it's a sign for you that there's a sense of weird cult-like behavior occurring within the organized crime group. You partying at a rally is not going to assist all the proclaims of your living in crisis. However, I remind you that Kamala Harris is the vice president, the current vice president. And you all have basically, not basically, turned your back on Joe Biden with the knowledge he is the current president. You have no sense of reality. You have no sense of self-respect. And if you have no self-respect, then you have no respect for others. You are willing and capable of doing some of the worst things that we've ever seen in human history, while no one stands up for what's right. They stand up for what is right in their money pocketbooks for Los Angeles. So all of California votes for Democrats because of people who are from other parts of the country who then go to California to rob the American people of their souls and their hardworking money so that they can fuel their egos that doesn't include confidence. They have no education. They sit on a platform and on a stage and occur as if their life is so perfect and they're so happy while telling you that you're worthless because they don't know how to be with a real human being. And these people of the Democrat regime, such as Lizzo, have taught new ways to abuse everyone around them, including your wife, your husband, your best friend, your spouses, your coworkers, and then she stands there with her white outfit, talking to Detroit voters, and it says, it's about damn time. Because she has a vagina, and so does Kamala Harris. Little does Lizzo know, she's just a chess piece in the pawn game to destroy women's lives. But as long as Lizzo is sitting at that pedestal, as long as she's sitting at that pedestal, she will do whatever it takes to you as audience, including put you into work camps. Where she'll then blame somebody else for the work camp. But you're already in a work camp. The work camp is going to work with her fans and followers. She has no emotion and no feeling around anything more than her low self-esteem, which then directly reflects onto the audience, where she eats like a pig in front of your face and says, now I'm on my fitness journey. Only out for one person and one person alone, and that is not what a politician is up to, not a real one. Not someone like Byron Donalds, who obviously has a lot of opposition and a lot of people supporting him in his journey of leadership. And that's part of the deal when you get a job in influence or Hollywood. Yet all you do is fluff the asses and tell people what they want to hear while uplifting them. And that is not how life works. Sorry if you're not getting your free ride like you want or your uplift. You didn't earn it. So you don't get it. And you drink too much. And you drink too much alcohol. And you drink too much beer. And you don't try or get curious about shit. You just violate people in their emotional state to create vulnerabilities in them that didn't exist until they met you. And then you get rewarded by overrunning someone else's power by bringing yourself to a higher level. Because you don't understand shit. It's why you're confused. Might want to rewind that and listen to that again about how they're putting you in your place when the real people that need to be put into place is Lizzo, a woman who doesn't even have an education. She just has a big fat mouth and a white suit. No education. Her only thing she has is an opinion that she was told to speak to by Kamala Harris. And if you ask me, the facts speak for themselves. That is not a democracy. The fact that you as an American civilization are dogging out infants and children and telling us that family are worthless so that women like Lizzo and men like Usher can show up to rallies, not to assist people in making logical decisions, but to manipulate you into buying your vote through partying, propaganda, and offensive uplift. You want to know what's going to happen once the election's done? And this, because the next person in office, which will be Donald Trump, doesn't occur until January. You want to know what's going to happen to you in the next few months? You're all going to be just little blips on their radar because you already cast your vote, where they will turn their back on you and figure out ways to get their bullshit in your face and leave you all behind while Lizzo tries to figure out how she's going to stay in her version of office. You're just pawns in the chess game of a bigger game that none of you even fucking understand, especially you influencers who are selling t-shirts and tickets to the most offensive, nastiest content that we've ever seen. Your personalities are garbage. There is no logics to you. And if there's no logics to you, how are you hosting podcasts, Paige Sorbo? Clearly an ignorant molester of men. Clearly an ignorant molester of men, Alex Earle. You're nasty. It's hard getting to someone who's so offensive in their ego to understand how nasty and disrespectful you are to men and women. Women want that power in their bodies? You have got to be kidding, because the same woman will yell out and cry out how she's been given a rough hand and men are the abusers, when the reality is you invited that behavior. You wanted that behavior until you meet the wrong one. So you can't be selective on what you put out when you're dealing with influencers, Kamala Harris. You want to know that she's literally provocative, Kamala Harris. She's out for herself, Kamala Harris. Attempting to destroy America, Kamala Harris. She's not American, she's an Indian Canadian, by the way. Lies about her mother being a doctor. If you're a doctor, you don't live in the projects. You don't grow up in a middle-class house if you're a doctor. You do get that, right? So all this conversation around the money that you're supposed to spend to earn your degree versus get a free handout, you either join the military, which is where your free college comes from, or you shut the hell up, make your choice, and do right by the American people while initiating a personal goal in mind. But that's not what these people want. They want money and they want fame, and they are willing to do whatever it fucking takes to get that fame and fortune while they destroy humanity, including self-respect, which they do not have, which is no confidence, which they pretend they have. While they annihilate you on a regular basis with every video they have, and they also include their children to demoralize humanity, creating the next generation creating the next generation to be offensive, more offensive than the last, to where our good kids have to battle it out with your nasty ass education.